Now available on Tata Sky channel number 526.
She is one of the most powerful women in the private equity space. She's also delivered some of the highest returns to investors in real estate. My colleague Amita Balachandra caught up with the executive vice chairman of Milestone Capital Advisors, Rubi Arya. She began by asking her about how difficult a journey it has been. Let's take a look.
Were there any challenges that you faced in the beginning when you took over, especially because you weren't from this background?
For the last 20 years, I had been in the corporate world, which of course meant that people management came naturally to me. In my previous life, I was taking care of 7,000 people, and that itself was a huge number of people to manage. But of course, when I took over this business, what was different is that, of course, the difficulty level was different. You were talking to and dealing with the best-in-class PE professionals. Stakeholders were equally, you know, different kinds of people. So yes, it was different. It wasn't difficult.
Let's talk about the biggest exit that happened a couple of years ago in the private equity space. Throw some light on that for us.
Okay, so just to tell you about the exit that we are talking about, you know, we had invested in this asset in July 2010, and that was not the time when people were buying into pre-leased core office assets, and we were probably the first ones to take that leap of faith and to put, you know, huge amounts of money. It was a 775 gross enterprise value deal in 2010, and that was a large deal. So, you know, we went and bought this asset when others were fearful. So I think, to me, the biggest part was that to buy into something when others were not able to, and when you are selling, there were so many people who wanted to buy the asset. I think that drove the price. Yeah. We were able to achieve a 9.5 exit cap rate on the asset and a 20% IRR.
Do you have more such exits planned over the next 1 year?
Yes.
Would you be able to give us some?
Sure. As we speak, the team has done a commendable job, and my partner has just closed a deal in Bangalore. Called the Electronic City, which is a standalone, building, which, we have sold off to Ultra HNI. So that is a deal that we will be, giving the proceeds of those, of that exit to the investors.
Yeah. Okay, now talking about the budget itself that happened recently, there's been a lot of push for affordable housing. So are you looking at lending to affordable housing developers?
So we, as I said, we believe in being the front runners in all the real estate sub-asset classes that we can talk about. Mm-hmm. And we've done 4 affordable housing projects in the past. Mm-hmm. One of the projects was in Ambivali in Kalyan, where we are exiting at a 20% IRR. Mm-hmm. We've done a project in NCR, which was again another affordable housing project. Mm-hmm. So we've done 4 affordable housing projects on the back of that, plus the incentives that the government has given to both the developer and the investor community. We will be lending increasingly for affordable housing as well.
You can watch live TV on our website mpnow.in. Find us on Facebook at facebook.com/magicbricksnow. And don't forget to click the like button. You can also follow us on Twitter at magicbricksnow. To stay updated with all our programming, hit the subscribe button on our YouTube channel by logging on to youtube.com/magicbricksnow.